What's going on, family? It's time we have a discussion about Mr. Drew Brees and his sentiments, right? So in the wake of everything that's going on in this country for the past few months and weeks, Black Americans are tired, right? Black Americans are experiencing and going through an uprising in America where we are voicing our outrage and we are voicing our disgust over having to watch our people get gunned down by law enforcement time and time again, right? We just experienced the murder of Mr. George Floyd in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And also, I just became aware of the murder of Breonna Taylor, an EMT worker who was a resident of Louisville, Kentucky, and the police barged into her home, the wrong home, and shot her 8 times and killed her. And in the wake of all of this, we all know that when sports begins, players are going to start to protest. They're going to express themselves, and they're starting to express themselves now in their sentiments about what's going on in this country. And so when asked his thoughts on players beginning the kneeling protest once again when the NFL season starts, the New Orleans Saints future Hall of Fame quarterback Drew Brees stated the following. He said, "I will never agree with anybody disrespecting the flag of the United States of America or our country." And that right there tells me that Drew Brees is extremely tone deaf and insensitive to the plight of African American people. He's been this way for a while now, and I realized it in 2016 when Colin Kaepernick first started the kneeling protest and how he responded. If y'all would have saw how Drew Brees responded to the kneeling protest when it first began, you would have thought somebody pissed in that man's Cheerios. You would have thought somebody slapped his kids or slapped his wife. The way he was just so, like, he was about to cry. Like, I mean, he was so enraged, and he was so tenacious, and he had, like, vitriol in his voice. Like, when he was discussing it, like, he wanted to go fight Colin Kaepernick head up. And me and my boy Melvin, like, what the hell is wrong with dude? Like, he about to cry or something. Like, bro, if you don't calm your ass down. But that's how he came across, right? And it lets me know that he was tone deaf then, and he is still tone deaf now, 4 years later. 4 years later, he still got the same sentiments. And even though he plays with a predominantly African-American team in the New Orleans Saints, most of his teammates are Black, and he plays in a Black city like New Orleans, Louisiana, where the majority population is Black, and they got all that rich Black culture, Drew Brees still feels the same way. He hasn't changed his thoughts one bit. And see, people, Drew Brees is the prime example why you shouldn't assume that just because a white person hangs out around a whole lot of Black people, he's always around Black people, that he understands the Black plight, right? Or Black issues in general. Because he absolutely doesn't, nor does he show any sensitivity towards it. And Drew keep representing what Cap did and why he did it. Time and time again, he keep making it about the flag after Colin Kaepernick has expressed that it was never about that. It was never about the troops or none of that, but he keeps making it about that. Time and time again. But again, since 2016, I realized what type of person Drew Brees is. Drew Brees, he always comes across as this all-American, Boy Scout, Scouts Honor type of guy. So with him, he can't see nothing past patriotism or the military when discussing issues about Black people or the kneeling protests in general. He can't see past the military at all, because he comes across as this pick yourself up by the bootstraps type of person. And he just comes across as the type of person that be like, you know, we have racism in this country, but it shouldn't stop you. It shouldn't stop you from doing things that you love to do. You gotta keep pushing forward, man. You gotta keep pushing forward. He seems like that type of guy, like, for real. And furthermore, like Bomani Jones alluded to this, I promise y'all, I don't know why, but I don't trust no white man to stand up for any Black issues if he is wearing Wrangler jeans. I don't know what it is about Wrangler, but I promise y'all, it's something about Wrangler jeans. I'd be like, hell no. Like, I just look at them like, he definitely not standing up for Black people. I don't know what it is, but when I see people, white people in Wrangler jeans, I'm like, he don't give a damn about what's going on with Black people in this country at all. But, you know, when Drew Brees is voicing how he feels about the protests and all of that, he always goes on these tangents and these stories about his grandfather's fighting in World War II, and he speaks so proudly about it and what that flag means to him and what the national anthem means to him. But he always seems to ignore the fact that Black soldiers fought in their very same war with his grandfathers, yet they had to come back to the United States and deal with Jim Crow laws and blatant racism, like voter suppression, housing discrimination, and so on and so forth. And they had to deal with white supremacy constantly, even after serving the country, right? And those two discrepancies tells a tale of two different Americas for two different ethnicities of people. Right. But Drew Brees only cares about what his version of America looks like and what it feels like for him. He's ignoring what it feels like for Black Americans. He's just pushing it to the back of his mind, and he's just pushing it to the back of his mind, and he really ignoring it in its entirety. Right. And that ain't cool at all. After all that's transpired in this country over the past few months and weeks concerning Black Americans and police brutality, Drew Brees still thinks that players are disrespecting the flag if they kneel. He still thinks that. It's just like, what the hell, bro? Like, what are you listening to? Are you listening to what you want to hear? Like, are you blatantly choosing to ignore the message of Black players? Are you really intentionally doing that? Because I'm looking like, fam, it's been explained to your ass time and time again, over and over again, and you keep on ignoring it and making it about what you want to make it about. Like, no. To Black Americans, it's a whole different thing. You know what I mean? And he don't want to recognize that or even acknowledges that he understands where Black people are coming from, right? And if Drew Brees thinks that kneeling during the anthem isn't the right way to do things, if he think it's not the right way to do things, then I want to ask him, what is the right way to do it? Because guess what? No matter how these athletes decide to protest police brutality, they're going to always be heavily ridiculed for it. No matter what, they always going to be heavily ridiculed for it, and it's always going to be a problem. It's always going to be a problem to people that always, come on, man, stop it, man. You know, it's no oppression in this country. It's no racism. Like, it's always going to be a problem to that type of crowd. The All Lives Matter type of crowd is always going to be a problem to them, right? And he went on to talk about his grandfathers fighting for this country and risking their lives to protect our country and try to make our country a better place for people and all this and all of that. And in many cases, he even said it brings him to tears when he hears the national anthem. Well, guess what, fam? A lot of Black families have been brought to tears because their family member has been killed at the hands of law enforcement, at the hands of people who are supposed to protect and serve, which is why Colin Kaepernick, Kenny Stills, Eric Reed, and several other black players were kneeling in the first place. That's the same why, the very reason why they were kneeling in the first place. And I'm going to tell you this, Drew Brees. Your grandfathers, just like the grandfathers of other Black men, fought for this country, and they were also very patriotic, right? However, what good is patriotism if Black Americans are not protected under it? I ask again, what good is all that patriotism if Black Americans are not protected under it? Because just like your grandfathers, it was a lot of Black Americans that was proud to be Americans, that was fighting for this country, even though they was going through all that bullshit. All that racism they was facing, all the bullshit they was getting hit with every left and right, and all this type of racism all the time. Getting told to ignore it, and it was a figment of their imagination, and all so on and so forth, and get over it, and keep fighting through it. And they was dealing with all that bullshit while serving this country. They came home and was getting discriminated against left and right. Right? So all that patriotism, what does that mean if Black Americans are not protected under it? Right? And even when I listen to Drew Brees talk, right? Not one time did Drew acknowledge that he understood the reasons for Colin Kaepernick's protests against police brutality, nor did he say he understand the anger and frustrations of many Black Americans at all. He didn't say that one time. He only spoke about what the flag meant to him. He never directly spoke about the murders of Breonna Taylor, again, who was shot 8 times while she was sleeping when police barged into the wrong home. He never acknowledged the murder of George Floyd, nor did he mention any of the injustices that Black people have been facing recently at all. He never even said it, and he never mentioned none of that in the discussion about the kneeling protest. He never mentioned none of the things we Black people have been experiencing recently when discussing the kneeling protest. But what he did do, he did post a black box on Instagram the other day, like he was standing up for injustices or some shit like that, or he was agreeing with the sentiments of Black Americans, like that meant something, posting that black box. Now let's talk about this black box thing on Instagram, right? Because that was really pissing me off, right? I'm not talking about the people that will really understand what it means and really are standing for what it means. But there was a lot of people who was posting that black box on Instagram just because it was trendy or in order to play it safe. And I know a lot of y'all that was doing that bullshit, right? A lot of people was doing that to play it safe. What do I mean by playing it safe? There are a lot of people in this country who don't want to tackle anything head on that deals with racial injustices or racism at all. So in order to avoid talking about it in its entirety or talking about any racial injustices, they posted that black box. Trying to think that they did something, like that meant something, right? Some of them was posting it like, they'll know I'm not racist if I post this. I won't have to make a statement as long as I post this black box. Yeah, that'll be acceptable. That'd be acceptable. Wrong. Because guess what? It was a lot of people who often got annoyed, you know, when people brought up discussions dealing with injustices against black people. And those same people who often get annoyed about talking about injustices or oppression against black people were also participating in the black box challenge on Instagram just because everybody else was doing it. Only because it was a trend. That was the only reason they was doing it, right? One of my closest friends who happens to live in North Carolina, where he's experienced racism his own self firsthand, told me that he saw individuals putting up that black box on Instagram that he knows are always opposing the black struggle or downplaying racism in any way possible, right? And he like, what the hell? Y'all just doing that shit just to be doing it because everybody else doing it. You really don't mean that in your heart. You trying to give off this impression that, hey, I won't have to talk about it if all I got to do is post that black box, and I'm in the clear. I won't have to attack it head on. I won't have to make a stance. Fam, in this time, you got to make a stance. Pick a side, fam. Ain't no pussyfooting on the subject. Ain't no toeing the line. Ain't no halfway doing it. Ain't no halfway stepping at all, right? And Drew Brees is being held accountable for not even expressing those sentiments or expressing that he understood the plight of African-American people and just feel like, oh, it's all about patriotism with him. He can't see past the military at all with the protests. And to be honest, Drew Brees could have said something along the lines of, I personally wouldn't kneel while during the national anthem, but as Colin Kaepernick and many others have expressed, there are racial injustices and police brutality in this country that are affecting the black community, and I understand their reasonings behind kneeling. It is an issue that needs to be addressed. All he had to say was something like that, and that would have been okay, right? That's all he had to say. But for him to just act like he just see it for what it is for him and talk about his grandfathers and all this, like other black men and fighting the army in that very same war and came back and was facing all that bullshit and racism when they came home, fam, get up out of here, bro. Get up out of here, man. And I promise y'all, man, like, when Drew Brees said that in 2016, I was looking at his ass like, bro, if you don't get your ass up out of here, like, I mean, like, he was about to, like, cry about the national anthem, bro. Like, if you don't, ain't nobody do nothing to your kids, your family, your wife, nobody that you love. Like, what are you talking about? Like, you just so enraged. I'm looking like, bro, get the hell up out of here. Like, for real. And again, it don't matter that Drew Brees plays in this black city, super black city, right? He's still tone deaf and he still is hearing what he wants to hear when it comes to the protest. He's still ain't acknowledging what Colin Kaepernick and many others did it for. Why they kneeled in the first place. He still won't acknowledge it. He still won't acknowledge that there is a problem with police brutality in America, especially against black people. He won't even understand it. He won't even say that he understands how black people feel. Right? He's still talking about the flag and all this, man. Like, I promise y'all, man. Like, if the world is really, you really finding out about people. I'm telling y'all, and he think posting that black box was his getaway and his way out with everything, so he don't have to say nothing to tackle the issue head on. Hell no. You gotta talk. Say something, and say something that means something. Don't just say a whole bunch of nothing, a whole bunch of bullshit, like Dabo Sweetie and them was saying, just a whole bunch of bullshit, a whole bunch of nothing, and think we gonna accept that and openly accept it and walk away. At least he said something. Hell no. We not riding with that, and we ain't falling for that, man. But again, man, he always talks about his grandfathers and all of that, like his grandfathers was the only one serving in the war. Black people were serving in that war too, fighting for those very same freedoms to make this world a better place, as he said before. And guess what? Guess what's still going on today? You still seeing black people get murdered while they unarmed and handcuffed and not a threat. So Drew Brees, you tell me what's that about. You tell me what's that about. And I wonder how his teammates are going to receive him during this season. Now, they're not going to mess up their money, but you seeing. What's my Michael Thomas and them express how they feeling towards Drew Brees for this stuff. And even Brian came out and said what he said about Drew Brees. You still want to see it for what you want to see it for, not what it's actually about. Time and time again, man, he come across as that all-American, you know, Boy Scout, Scout Sauna type of guy all the time. And he loses me every time he do that. Every time. I don't fool with that shit, man. And he know what time it is. He's scared to say it. He don't want to say it. And he don't want to talk about it. And he only want to see it for what it is. Fam, he know what's going on. I say he don't understand the black plight. He know what's going on in America. But until he walks in our heat, because he don't walk in our shoes, because he don't got this black skin on him, he don't identify with it. And it's never going to mean nothing to him at all. It's never going to mean nothing to him. No matter what city he's in or how many black teammates he got, it ain't going to mean nothing to him. You know, and it's just crazy, man. Like, to see him still feeling like this all these years, you got 4 years to think on it, right? All these recent events, all these events that have happened recently involving black Americans getting killed by law enforcement, you still can't even acknowledge, like, you understand that there is a problem with police brutality in this country against black people. And there are injustices that black people face. He still won't come out and admit that. True Breeze, fam, like, his ass is tone deaf, but he's been able to get away with it for so long because he plays football very, very well. He been able to just let it slide and let it ride. No, man, we got to start asking. Like, when them interviews come, ask Drew Brees some real questions. Do you know what's going on in America? Have you been seeing what's happening to black people? Do you understand? Can't you understand that's why Colin Kaepernick was protesting in the first place? Can't you understand black people's frustration with what's going on? All he said was, yeah, it's not a lot of perfect things going on. There's things that are wrong in this country. No, don't say things. Say what it is that's wrong. Talk about it. Talk about it specifically. Don't beat around the bush. Ain't no time for that. Ain't no time for that at all. Coming with that type of rhetoric and, you know, all those type of feelings and sentiments at this time, nah. You know? Nah. It's just... I promise y'all, he seems very, very nonchalant towards the black struggle, what's going on, plight of black people. Still seems that way after 4 years has passed and everything that's been going on recently, man. For real. But yeah, man, I don't, like, people gotta start asking Drew Brees the real stuff in these interviews and make him come to a realization of what, like, look at what you're saying with this. Bring up them facts. Your grandfather fought in the army. There's a lot of other black people, grandfathers and great-grandfathers fought in the wars and still was treated like nothing when they came home. Treated like next to nothing when they came home. Still had to go in different, couldn't eat in certain restaurants, couldn't get a meal from certain places, wouldn't be served because of the color of their skin. Come on, man. For real, like, I that black box challenge really pissed me off because I knew a lot of people was trying to get away with just posting the black box and don't want to speak on the real issues. No, fam, you got to talk. Say what, talk about what's real. You ain't going to get no props and no kudos from us because you just posting that black box like you did some shit, like you did some. Hell no. No. It ain't sliding. We ain't letting that ride, man. Machiavelli Mills TV, I'm out.